The U Policy Lab was established 5 years ago. It's part of a bigger part of the European Commission, which is the Joint Research Center. And maybe to tell you a little bit about the EU Policy Lab, I need to explain a little bit what the Joint Research Center is. So the European Commission is divided in Director Generals, basically Director General for Health, or for Finance, or for Industries. And the Joint Research Center is a dedicated Director General just to provide research for policy. The EU Policy Lab was established 5 years ago as part of the GRC, as we call it. And it was because the GRC felt that just providing scientific evidence for policy was not enough in these times of uncertainty, and we needed a little bit more of public policy innovation. So this is how the GRC started. It was done, in fact, by direct request of the Director General of the GRC. So we sit directly under the Director General, if that makes sense. And at the beginning, it basically had two initial teams, and it was quite small. It was around 15 people. And it basically had behavioral insights and foresight teams. So basically, one looking into the future and the other one trying to more or less make a behavioral change onto the present and also into the future, but more into the present. Basically, in the last 5 years, we grew a lot. We now just absorbed the team on modeling, which is a little bit more quantitative compared to what the Policy Lab used to do in terms of experimentation. And now we are around 50 people and we have more than 30 projects running. Most of our projects are basically, you know, one-off requests coming from the rest of the European Commission. So imagine a part of the European Commission wants to know about the future of taxation. You know, how would taxation look like in 2030? So we can conduct a study for them, we can do a more, you know, a one-year study, we can engage stakeholders, we can do our own research, we can work with experts. We also do a lot of, you know, on-request services. So imagine a big event will show up in Brussels and it needs to be more lively, or it needs to be a little bit more fresh, let's call it that. So the EU Policy Lab also acts as sort of an interface between the policy and the citizens. So we also do a lot of citizen engagement, we do a lot of co-creation alongside with the Futures and with the Behavioral Insights team, and that's it. It's true that we do a lot of experimentation, we do a lot of anticipation work, we also work a lot with behavioral change, but at the end of the day, our main core business is providing evidence for policy. If we don't manage to produce evidence about it, it's not useful. You know, we can, for example, we can work with one project, we can be quite successful in it, but what comes after? You know, what about other policy labs? What about other innovation units in the world? What can they learn from us? So even if we are always in the business of providing evidence for policymakers, we also want to provide evidence for other researchers. So we publish, we do a lot of fundamental research also, and there's not one project at all that we conduct that doesn't have at least one hint of research in it. I see Policy Lab as being, you know, between closer to citizens or closer to the ground level, closer to implementation, and policy labs that are kind of closer to the top, the high level of public administration. And we are one of those. We don't interact directly with citizens, even if in the projects we do, but in terms of implementation, we don't go there. But we provide the services or the knowledge or the support or the experimentation for the part of the European Commission that then go into the citizens, may it be by funding, regulation, may it be by, you know, support to citizen initiatives. So the EU Policy Lab is quite, we call it a hybrid beast, because we come from a research institution, but we do experimentation, we work with citizens all the time in our projects, we do a lot of engagement with stakeholders, coming from industry, businesses, academia, NGOs, CSOs, but at the end of the day, we deliver it to the policy director general of the commission in charge of that file. May it be finance or taxation or farming, they are the ones that take our results and take our project and run with it. Even if some of us also do a lot of theoretical research, not all of us. So for example, we have We have designers in our team. One of them, she does a lot of theoretical research. The other does more practical work. In Foresight, some of us do theoretical work, the others do more practical work. Some of us mix it all. For example, I mix it all. I publish, but I also do a lot of practical work. I even do some implementation with some projects that I have. So sometimes it really depends on the week. For example, right now we have ongoing future of government, future of taxation, a lot of futures. Future of farming, a new project on blockchain. And these are like really long way projects of 1 year, 2 years. But we also do, depending on the week, there might be a request and then five of us just drop everything and we start working on that specific request. This request can come from, for example, a commissioner's cabinet. There's going to be a big event on SDGs or on climate change, and they want to have a different look beyond the traditional research. So they can come to us. And for example, we can conduct a stakeholder workshop. We do a lot of role playing also. We do a lot of horizon scanning. So we use a lot of non-traditional techniques, but a lot of more frontier techniques to basically play a little bit with what the research can offer. So we use these frontier techniques to conduct our research. We use it to experiment with the research results from others. So for example, from other parts of the GRC that do research on standards, on health, on biochemicals, on genomics, you know. Wherever you want research, the GRC has it. So we can also work with some of these units and try to bring their work, their research results into a different field. Try to do a different interface between science and policy. Because at the end of the day, this is what the GRC is. And this is what also the EU Policy Lab is, because the identity of the Policy Lab is not that different from the identity of the GRC. It's just that we are a little bit faster, maybe, and we are a bit more forward-looking and experimental. But again, research, core business.